Hi everyone, this is Sunanda Manke and you are watching my YouTube channel Concept Tech 2018. It is a virtual class for engineering students, especially for electronics, computer science and IT branches. On this channel, all videos are narrated in both Hindi and English language to make the concept easier to grasp. In this video of 8085, we learn about the machine cycles and how to draw timing diagram and related concepts. This is part 1 where we will discuss timing diagrams for different machine cycles, and in the second part we will learn to draw timing diagram for different instructions taking various examples. What is a machine cycle? It basically is the time taken by the processor to perform a single operation. Each machine cycle is divided into T states or clock cycles. Similarly, time taken by the processor to perform one instruction is called a instruction cycle. Instruction cycle consists of one or more machine cycles. So, we have number of T states which makes a machine cycle, and number of machine cycles making an instruction cycle. Now, we'll list different machine cycles of 8085. That is different operations performed by the processor. Here we have opcode fetch, memory read, memory write, IO read, IO write, interrupt acknowledgement, halt, hold and reset. Now we will see the corresponding values of different control and status signals. We will start with IOM bar. IOM bar goes low when microprocessor performs memory related operation, and it goes high when microprocessor performs IO related operations. So for opcode fetch, memory read and memory write, it is low, and for IO read, IO write and interrupt acknowledgement, which again is IO related operation, its value is high. For remaining machine cycles, its value is Z. S0 and S1 are status lines, and their value is 1 for opcode fetch. When any reading operation is performed, the value of S0, S1 is 10. For writing operation, it is 01, and for halt, it is 00. It has 11 value for interrupt acknowledgement as well. Then we have read bar signal. Read bar signal goes low only when microprocessor performs reading operation. And write bar signal goes low when microprocessor performs writing operation. Lastly, we have interrupt acknowledgement, that is INTA bar. This signal goes low only when microprocessor receives INTR interrupt. It acknowledges this interrupt using INTA bar. And INTA bar is used as read bar signal by the processor. Here X and Z. Z is for high impedance state and X is unspecified. So for hold and reset condition, we have these values for different control signals. Coming again to the instruction cycle, it is the time taken by the processor to complete one instruction, and as discussed before, it consists of one or more machine cycles. Every instruction has two parts, opcode and operand. Instructions are either 1 byte, 2 byte or 3 byte long in case of 8085. And the first machine cycle of any instruction cycle is always opcode fetch. Basically, it reads opcode and then it performs operations depending on the value of this code. Coming to the timing diagram, it is the graphical representation of execution time of the processor for any instruction, and it represents specific instruction cycle in terms of machine cycles and T states. That is, timing diagram is drawn for different instruction cycles. One T state represents the operation carried out in one clock period, as shown here. This is the clock period. One clock period is mentioned clock can have 0 value and 1 value, and here we have shown rise time and fall time as well. Coming to the discussion of how the timing diagram is drawn. Well, timing diagram is drawn for a specific instruction, as I told you in the previous slide, and that instruction is written at a specific location. Here we have taken an example. In this example, the instruction is written as 2000H. It is the memory location, and the instruction written is move AB, and its opcode is 78H. So at memory location 2000H, 78H is written. Now we need to know the following values to draw the timing diagram. First of all, it is the address where the instruction is written. In this example, it is 2000H. So in this 2000H, higher order address is 20H and lower order address is 00H. So A8 to A15 20H and A0 to A7 00H. Then we need to know the opcode of the instruction. Here it is 78H. So data lines have 78H on it, that is D0 to D7 is 78H. Then we need to know the number of machine cycles required for particular instruction. In this case, it requires single machine cycle. And lastly, we need to know the number of T states required. In this case, only one machine cycle, and it requires 4 T states. Now, where do we get this information, number of machine cycles and T states? Basically, it is written in the data sheet of 8085. It is fixed for each and every instruction. Now, we have all the requisite information to draw the timing diagram. So, we'll see step by step how the timing diagrams are drawn. First of all, we have to mark the number of T states column wise. Okay. Then we'll draw the clock cycles, one clock in each T state, and we'll mark the machine cycles for the total clock cycles. Next, we'll draw the higher order address bus and mark the content of the higher order address bus. Then we'll draw ALE signal, address latch enable, and this signal goes high for the first clock cycle of every machine cycle. So we'll make it high for the first clock cycle and we'll make it low for the remaining clocks. After that, we'll draw lower order multiplexed address data bus, AD0 to AD7, which will contain address when ALE is high, and for the remaining two clock cycles, it will contain data. For this particular example, address is 00H and data is 78H. Lastly, we have to draw the control signals IOM bar, read bar, write bar, and status signals S0 and S1. First of all, we'll take timing diagrams of specific machine cycles. And in the second part, we'll take certain examples for drawing timing diagram. We'll start with opcode fetch. As discussed earlier, this is the first machine cycle of every instruction cycle, and it requires either 4 T states or 6 T states. This particular diagram is for 4 T states. So 4 clock cycles are drawn first. Then higher order address bus contains address for 3 clock cycles. Multiplex address data bus contains lower order address for the first clock cycle and data, or in this case opcode, for the next 2 clock cycles. ALE goes high for the first clock cycle. IOM bar will have low value throughout the cycle because it's a memory related operation. Being opcode fetch machine cycle, S0 and S1 will have high value as discussed in the previous table. As this is a memory read operation, only read bar control signal will be used, and read bar will have low value for 2 clock cycles T2 and T3 when there is data on the address data bus. Okay. The next example, the next machine cycle is memory read and memory write. Memory read is exactly similar to opcode fetch, because in opcode fetch also we are reading the memory. The difference here is opcode fetch had 4 T states, and in the last T state it was basically decoding the code. So it wasn't, there wasn't any information on the timing diagram as such. It was the decoding part which is done by the processor in the last clock cycle. But in case of memory read, it requires only 3 clock cycles. So 3 clock cycles are drawn, rest of the signals are exactly same. Higher order address bus contains address for 3 clock cycle. Multiplex address data bus contains lower order address for the first clock cycle, data for the next 2 clock cycles, ALE goes high for the first clock cycle. IO mbar is low as it is memory related operation, and yes, S1, S0 are 0, 1 here compared to 1, 1 that was there with the opcode fetch. And lastly, the read bar signal is low for the 2 clock cycles when there is data on the address data bus. Memory write signal, timing diagram is exactly same as memory read. The difference is in the control signal. Instead of read bar, we have write bar signal here. Write bar goes low for 2 clock cycles T2 and T3 when there is data loaded by the processor on the data lines. In case of read bar, data is read by the processor, and in case of write bar, data is given by the processor. S1 and S0 in case of memory read, S0 was 0, S1 was 1. In this case, S1 is 0 and S0 is 1. Coming to IO read and IO write cycles, they also require 3 T states. The difference is in the IO mbar signal. In case of IO read and IO write, it is IO related operation. So IO mbar is high, and rest of the signals are exactly same. For IO read, they are same as memory read, and for IO write, they are same as memory write. We'll have a quick recap of what we have seen in this slideshow. Timing diagram is a graphical representation of timing details. Each instruction cycle consists of one or more machine cycles, and machine cycle consists of one or more T states. First machine cycle is always opcode fetch for every instruction, and timing diagram contains the status of address lines, data lines, control and status signals for all the instructions. Lastly, ALE goes high for the first clock cycle of machine cycle, and when ALE is high, address data bus contains address, otherwise it contains data. I hope the first part is clear to you. We'll discuss the different examples in the second part of this presentation. There are more videos on 8085 processor on my channel as shown in this slide. To understand 8085 fully, you can view them all, and if you like them, you can subscribe my channel Concept Tech 2018 for videos on other topics as well. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope by watching this, you have gained what you aimed for. Thanks again.